fellow golfers. It's Mike with Hansen Fitness for Golf in Irvine, California. And in this video, we're talking about the two B's. That's butt and balance. So basically, we're talking about lower body stability in the golf swing. So if you're someone that tends to get all over it with your lower body, or you come forward in your downswing, or you feel like you can't finish or you don't have balance, then this video is for you. I'm going to show you three exercises on how to strengthen your glutes or even get a better relationship with your glutes, because a lot of people don't know how to use them. And I'm going to give you three exercises that are going to improve your balance overall. So stay tuned. Okay, so in the intro, I mentioned having a better relationship with your glutes or your butt. So a lot of people, I would say 9 out of 10 people that come in and do our glute strengthening test, fail it because no one can understand how to fire the glutes. And if you're watching this video, you can stand up, or if you're already standing, then just try and squeeze your butt cheeks, but don't use any other muscle. And if you can do that, you can try one glute at a time. I'm serious. It's a good test to see if you have control over your glutes. And if you don't, it's really hard to use them in your golf swing. So we're going to take this step by step. So the first thing you want to do is lay down on your back with your knees bent. And just try and feel like your pelvis or your belt is going to come towards your chin, and you're going to squeeze your butt muscles. You can even put your hands on the sides to make sure they're squeezing. I once had a client that actually squeezed. When I asked her if she was squeezing, she said yes. But we want to make sure the muscle is squeezing, not the hand. And then we're going to take the hands off the floor, so we're not using those for stability. You want to feel like your glutes are squeezing together. My best analogy is you're in an elevator, you and one other person, and you have to go to the 100th floor, and you have really bad gas, and you can't let it out. You got to squeeze your glutes together. And I want you to hold it for about 60 seconds, because you may not feel it at first, but as you hold this position, you want to feel it in the glute. A lot of people will feel it in the hamstring. A lot of people will feel it in the lower back. And one of the best ways to get a better relationship with your glutes is just to hold it. So that's exercise number one. Lay there and hold the glute muscles. You might feel a cramp in your glutes. That's awesome if you do. Okay. Exercise number two, and it's only move on if you can feel this exercise in your glute. You're going to come up like this, and then from this position, you're gonna raise one leg straight out. Now, what you wanna make sure is that when you raise, don't feel like your hip drops. You wanna make sure that you're going up, and one of the best tips is push through the heel of the foot that's on the ground. So you wanna push up through the heel and hold that. And then we're gonna hold it for about 5 to 10 seconds and then switch sides. If you're feeling that in the hamstring or the glute, go back to the first exercise. So there's your first two exercises for better glutes. Okay, so we got the ones on the ground. Now, if you felt that or if you didn't feel that, this is always my go-to with clients, that if I want to really get them to understand how to fire the glutes or what it's supposed to feel like for the glutes, I always go to this one. And it's called band walks. And there's two big groups of muscles in the glutes. There's a glute maximus and there's a glute medius. So this is going to work more of the medius on the sides, but it's also going to hit the maximus too. So what you want to do is you want to put a band around both legs, and you want to make sure that you keep your toes pointed in. This is important to get the glute medius. If you go toes out, you're going to recruit these hip flexor muscles, and we don't want to strengthen those right now. So what we're going to do is you're going to go toes in, take a step, try and keep your body square, and then step in this way. So try not to drag the back foot. I see a lot of people want to do that. Try not to drag that back foot, and then you go back and forth. So about 5 steps each way, keeping the toes pointed in. That's gonna really fire those glutes, and probably do about 15 to 20 of those. Now, if you say, I don't have a band like this, if you do have any other type of resistance tubing, this is how you can do it here. So you just take your band, step on it like this, cross here, and now we're gonna go toes in and then step. So now you're getting that same resistance and you're getting a good shoulder workout. Keep your shoulder blades back, pinch the shoulder blades, and you're gonna get a glute and an upper back exercise. So that's the third exercise for the glutes. It's a tough one, but it's a great one. So if you're wondering why I put balance and the glutes together is because the stronger your glutes, the better balance is going to be. So if you're one that when you try and balance and you're all over the place, or you feel it in your ankle, you feel it in your calf, you should be feeling your glutes. And that mind-muscle connection, once you learn how to use your glutes, it'll start to use the more efficient muscle, which being the glute. So what we want to do, I'm going to take you through three levels. So the first thing is just trying to balance and trying to feel the glute muscle. So I really recommend, I always say get them while they're hot. After you do the side walks, try standing on one leg, because your mind has a good connection with that glute medius, and then just stand here. And if you want to get into your golf posture, that's going to help you to hinge back so you feel that in your glute just a little bit more. So just standing there, try 15 to 20 seconds. Try to get that feeling in the glute when you're balancing. That's exercise number one. Next one is going to be, each time we're going to give you a little bit of a more unstable surface to try and practice on. All right, so I said I'm gonna make the ground a little unstable, so I have a pad here, and this pad is really nice. I think it's called a balance pad. If you don't have a pad like this, I recommend using a pillow or something at home. Just make sure it's not one that somebody else in your family is sleeping on. And so what you're gonna do is you're gonna stand on it, and what you're gonna notice is your foot wants to go different directions. And all that's doing is your mind's trying to figure out, where am I in balance? So what happens, it'll send a sensory that I want to go out, and then your mind says, wait, I got to go back, I got to go out. So that's where the shaking is, and eventually you're going to really learn how to maintain that balance or not overcompensate when you're going back. And again, you want to feel that in the glute. And you always want to do it on both sides. And what I recommend is once you get good at this and you can really balance, you can start to get some movement in. So you can start to rotate your upper body, and that's gonna really improve that balance. Okay, so for the third and final step, I want you to gradually move up to these, but we use a balance board in here a lot, and what this does is it allows us to really focus on that lateral movement, or this is really strengthening the ankle, and you're also recruiting the glute. I recommend holding on to something when you first try it if you do have a balance board. So what you wanna do is just, if you're holding on to something, the least amount is gonna really improve. So you can grip it really tight till your knuckles are white, or you can go one finger and it's probably gonna be the same. So if you can just go one finger and balance, it's gonna do wonders for your ankle or the muscle, the glute muscle that you're trying to recruit there. So this one is great to go back and forth or side to side and really strengthen that lateral movement of the ankle. Because when we take a downswing, we always want to make sure that we're getting that weight going laterally towards the target and not forward towards the ball. So that's a really good one. The other one is we use a Bosu ball. You can use it on either side. This one's really great because it's going to train in all directions. So you want to make sure your foot's in the middle of it, and again, holding on to something if you need to. But you can start to move the ball around like this, again trying to get the glute, or you can start to move your upper body around as you get better with the Bosu ball. So three different levels. One's on the ground, next is a little bit more unstable floor, and then the third one is a much more unstable. And as you get better with that, your golf swing is definitely going to improve with your lower body stability. So if you're looking for more consistency in your swing, those are the exercises that you want to focus on. I have a saying is you can only swing as fast as what you could slow down. So if you can only get to here and your balance goes and you fall over, then you're not going to swing very fast, because in your subconscious mind you're thinking, I need to be able to stand up or not fall over. So the more stability and balance you have on your lead side, most people on your right-handed golfers for your left side, so the more balance and stability you have over here, the more you can swing easier with more confidence and a lot faster. So those three exercises, get in a relationship with your glutes, learn how to use them, strengthen them by doing the one leg bridge, and then, but all else fails, strengthen the glute medius by doing the band walks. And that's gonna really improve your balance. That's why I put those two together. And then challenge your balance. Start on the ground, work your way up, move around a little bit, do the unstable surface, and then at the end, if you get really good, just try balancing on things, but be careful when you do it. So Check out the rest of our videos. If you haven't done our at-home golf fitness assessment, I recommend that you go back and check that out if you're on the blog here. If you're on YouTube, head over to our blog at hansenfitnessforgolf.com, and we'll see you next time on the next video.